Hello world and welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. I hope for everyone who's watching this video that you are doing great. I'm fine as well. So let's talk about data ingestion into Azure Sentinel. And especially data ingestion when there is no connector available. Currently there are multiple methods for ingesting data into Azure Sentinel. One of the methods, and which I really prefer, is by making use of the Azure Sentinel connectors. They are really easy to set up and they are here for Microsoft solutions and third-party solutions as well. Next, there is also the Log Analytics API. As you may know, Log Analytics is the data store that is used by Azure Sentinel. There is an API available which you can use for data ingestion. But it's quite hard to use. You need to be, well, some kind of a programmer. You need to build a logic app or a small application to ingest data into it. And lastly, there is also Logstash. And Logstash is part of the Elk stack. Logstash basically is a data pipeline. We can grab data from somewhere, filter it, and output it to another source. So, how is Logstash built up? It's built up out of plugins. We have plugins to collect data and we have plugins to push data into another source. And the great thing is that there are different plugins available for Logstash than connectors for Azure Sentinel. So if you are working with an application and there is no connector available in Azure Sentinel, it might be that there is a plugin available in Logstash. So in this Azure vlog, we are going to explore Logstash. I'm going to show you how you can get data by using a plugin in Logstash and how we can output it to Azure Sentinel. So without further ado, let's grab a really nice cup of coffee and I'll show you how you can work with Logstash in combination with Azure Sentinel. So before I'm going to show you how you can configure Logstash to connect to Azure Sentinel, I thought it would be helpful to show you where we are coming from, as Logstash is not a Microsoft solution, but a solution by a company called Elastic. Logstash is part of the Elk stack. Elk basically stands for Elasticsearch, Logstash, and Kibana. And these are applications that are used in combination with each other quite often. Logstash is a data transformation tool. Elasticsearch is a search optimized database. And Kibana is a tool that we can use to visualize data in that Elasticsearch database. We often now see file beats being used with Logstash, Elasticsearch, and Kibana together. And file beats basically helps collecting data out of log files and pushes it over to Logstash to further process it over there. So if we zoom in for a little bit on Logstash, you see it consists of three main components: a input component, a filter component, and an output component. And these components are filled in with plugins. So we have input plugins to collect data. We have filter plugins to transform the data and do something with it. And we have output plugins to send our transformed data over to another data source. And let me give you a quick overview of the plugins that are available. So for the input plugins, we have a Azure Event Hub plugin. This plugin is able to get data out of an Azure Event Hub. We have a CloudWatch plugin, an Elasticsearch plugin, which can collect data out of the Elasticsearch database. We have a GitHub plugin, which is able to collect data from GitHub. We have a Graphite plugin. A really interesting plugin over here is the JDBC plugin, which is the Java database driver component. And this plugin can be very helpful if you are having an application which stores all its logs into a database. You can use this plugin to collect the data out of the database and send it in the end over to Azure Sentinel. We have filter plugins available. One that I think is really interesting is the GeoIP plugin, which is able to enrich an IP address with geographical information. There is also a Sitter plugin available, which is helpful when dealing with IP addresses and processing them. A D-dot plugin, which is helpful when you have to remove a lot of dots in your data. A lot of plugins are available over there. There are also output plugins. So we have CloudWatch also there. We can output to a CSV file, output to the Elasticsearch database, output to email, and there is an output for Azure Log Analytics. And this plugin is quite interesting in the solution that I'm going to demo you in a minute. For both input, filter, and output plugins, this is just a small piece of the plugins that are available there. There are lots and lots of more plugins. So, as I mentioned earlier, we have a Log Analytics output plugin. And this plugin is open source and it's on the Azure Sentinel GitHub page. The Azure Sentinel GitHub page is managed by Microsoft, but it's open source. If you want to contribute to it, you are able to do that. And you can also have a view in the code, etc. So let's now dive a little bit deeper. Logstash, as you saw earlier, is basically a data transformation pipeline, and of course we have to configure it. And Logstash actually has not a graphical user interface, so we have to do that by using configuration files. If we have a look at the configuration over here, you see the three main parts of it: input, filter, and output. If you have a look at the input section over here, you'll see the TCP plugin is defined and we have some configuration for it. There's currently no filtering plugin defined over here, so we are directly forwarding everything that is collected by the input plugin. We are forwarding it to the output plugin. And the output plugin, what we see over here, is the Azure Log Analytics output plugin. You need to configure a workspace ID and a workspace key in your configuration file, and a table name there where the data is getting stored. If we deploy this configuration to our Logstash server, it will directly forward all the data from the TCP plugin to our log analytics. So for the demo I'm going to show you, I have an environment prepared. I have a virtual machine, which is a quite small and cheap virtual machine. It's a B1 MS size, which is one CPU, and it has only 2 GB. It's a burstable VM, so this is not for production situations. And I have installed Ubuntu 18.04 on it. The Logstash service is installed over there. I made use of a really good tutorial on the internet, which I will link to in the description of this video, if you want to set up Logstash yourself. And that Logstash instance that's installed will forward data to Azure Sentinel. So I'm here in the Azure portal and I have a Azure Sentinel workspace opened. Today we are not going to do a lot in the Azure Sentinel user interface. I want you to make note of one thing, and that is the workspace ID and the workspace key that is being used by the Log Analytics workspace, which you are using with Azure Sentinel. And I will show you how you can find it. If we are going to settings, go to workspace settings. We are here in the settings of the Log Analytics workspace that is being used by Azure Sentinel. If we are going to agents management over here, here we have the workspace ID, and here we have the keys that you can use. Please make note of the workspace ID and your primary key. You later need them when we are configuring Logstash. So if I close down this portal, I have a bash shell open here to my Ubuntu VM on which Logstash is installed. So before I was able to ingest data into my Azure Sentinel workspace, I had to make sure that the Log Analytics plugin is installed. So what I did is I run this command, the Logstash plugin install, and then the Microsoft Logstash output Azure Sentinel Log Analytics plugin was selected over there. I run this. I don't know how it's working now, as it is already installed. So let us have a look. So it's installing the plugin again, and it's now finished. That is a really nice experience. So let me show you the config that I'm using on this particular Logstash instance. So here you see I have one input plugin defined, which is the Twitter plugin. And what it basically does, it will get all tweets where the keyword cyber is being used. We are not transforming or processing the information. There's no filter plugin available. And then we output this to the plugin that we just installed, the Microsoft Logstash output Azure Log Analytics plugin. And here you have to define your workspace ID and your workspace key. We also have to define our table where we want our tweets to get stored. So let's run this Logstash pipeline. Let me find the command over here. Yes, here it is. So it's now starting up the Java virtual machine, which is being used by Logstash. So Logstash is now starting up. And we see that it is working. Here you see there's one item posted into Log Analytics. Here, 3 others are posted. So Logstash is in the background now crawling Twitter for all tweets that are containing the keyword cyber, and is posting them into Azure Sentinel. So this will run for a minute in the background. So I'm back on my Azure Sentinel workspace right now. Let's go to logs. And you'll see that a new menu item over here called Custom Logs has been appeared. And you see that I have a table tweets over here. Ignore the tweet table over here. This was from a test that I did earlier. And if we double click on it, it will show us the tweets that are in there. One thing to mention over here, if you're experimenting with Logstash and Azure Sentinel, be aware that there is a ingestion time of around 4 to 5 minutes. So that means when you start Logstash and you see that it has ingested a log item into your Azure Sentinel instance, you probably will see it only 5 minutes later in the Azure Sentinel workspace. So let's quickly explore one of the tweets. So you can see a lot over here. Much more information actually than is visible in the Twitter web interface. But let me show the tweets that were done. Project text. So and here we have the tweets. So this is quite a nice situation. If for your application a Logstash plugin is available but not a Azure Sentinel connector, you are able to submit the log data into Azure Sentinel by making use of Logstash. So in this Azure vlog, you saw how we can use Logstash in combination with Azure Sentinel. If you are working with an application that doesn't have a native Azure Sentinel connector available, it might be that there is a solution in Logstash. Being it a plugin that directly connects to your application, or by using one of the plugins that plugs into the infrastructure of your application, being it an HTTP API or maybe the database with the Java database connection plugin. Logstash is not an integrated solution into Azure Sentinel. It requires you to spin up a container or a Linux virtual machine where you can run Logstash as a daemon. And with that, I would like to close this vlog. I hope you liked it. If you thought it is helpful, please hit the thumbs up button. Of course, subscribe to this channel and ring the notification bell so you will get a notification when I upload a new video. And of course, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.